Welcome back. During this next segment, it has been statistically proven that more people leave to go get a drink of water than any other portion of our show. Here's this week's Turtin' Back Time.
Hey. If I could turn back time.
Even the co-hosts, even the, all right. April 1st, today, it's a big day for symbols. In 1778, Oliver Pollock, a New Orleans businessman, creates the dollar sign. Uh-huh. And in 1976, Apple Computer, the company founded by Steve Jobs, Steve Wozniak, and Robert Wayne, yep, there it is, that's the symbol behind it. Their first product was the Apple I personal computer kit, which sold for $666.66.
That's very specific.
Yes, they were. A happy birthday to Lon Chaney. There's your original Phantom of the Opera right there. Uh-huh. He was born in 1883. Now, on April 2nd, 1902, the first full-time U.S. movie theater, Tally's Electric Theater. That opened in Los Angeles. It only lasted 6 months.
I guess they didn't think movies were going to be a thing.
It's just all that talking and lots of things. All right. In 1956, both Edge of Night and As the World Turns debuted on television. Happy birthday to Buddy Ebsen, born in 1908 from the Beverly Hillbillies. And some people don't realize he was originally cast as the Tin Man in Wizard of Oz, but he had an allergy to the makeup. And he had to quit.
I love him.
Yeah, and originally he was going to be the Scarecrow, but yeah. Ray Bolger
he actually
traded
looks like
with
a
him.
Scarecrow.
Yeah. In 1882, on April 3rd, Jesse James is shot and killed by a member of his own gang to collect the reward of $10,000. Now, in 1973,
how much was that worth?
Yeah, well, $10,000 would be worth a lot.
Yeah.
But in 1973, the first portable cell phone call is made. General manager of Motorola's communication system division calls his rival at AT&T's Bell Labs from the streets of New York City.
That's huge.
And it wasn't to give advice. It was really to poke him in the eye and say, ha, 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 ha. Yeah. A happy birthday goes out to Tony Orlando, born in 1944, and Virgil Gus Grissom. 1926, second American in space. Now, on April 4th, which is this Thursday, 1968, Martin Luther King is assassinated in Memphis, Tennessee by James Earl Ray. In 1887, the first U.S. woman elected mayor, Dora Salter, is elected by Angonia, Kansas, nominated as a prank. She didn't find out she was running until the morning of the election, and she received 2/3 of the vote. The big deal about this is she was nominated by a group of men who thought that women had no place in politics.
I guess people were ready for change, huh?
She won.
Yeah.
A happy birthday goes out to Robert Downey Jr., born in 1965, Iron Man, that kind of stuff, and Mickey Owen, born in 1916. Dropped third strike in 1941 World Series, let the Yankees beat the Dodgers.
He retired here in Springfield, too,
Yes, he is an Ozarks guy. Mm-hmm. All right, on April 5th in 1614, Pocahontas marries Captain John Rolfe after she was told that Captain John Smith had died. And then she subsequently traveled to England. Happy birthday to Betty Davis. And this is one of the great quotes. You know, she was not a fan of Joan Crawford. They fought a lot. There have been movies about that and everything. She supposedly said, "You should never say bad things about the dead. You should only say good." Joan Crawford is dead. Good.
That's awesome.
That's her quote. And that wraps it up for the latest mind-boggling edition of Turtin' Back Time.
If I could turn back time.